Hello students, today we will work out on some numerical problems based on our previous topic that we have gone through. And from your NCERT exercise, you can see a question 5.7. What will be the pressure exerted in Pascal by a mixture of 3.2 grams of methane and 4.4 grams of carbon dioxide contained in 9 decimeter cube flask at 27 degree centigrade. So, we have to find out the pressure of the mixture. So, pressure of the mixture we have to find out. So, we have the two gases, one is methane gas and another is carbon dioxide gas. So, I will write now methane gas here and carbon dioxide gas here. Okay. Now, the mass is given. So, mass of methane gas is 3.4 grams, sorry 3.2 grams, whereas the molar mass of methane we know, that is 16, 12 contribution of carbon and 4 from hydrogen, those 16 gram per mole. So, the number of moles will be 3.2 gram divided by 16 gram per mole. Okay, so 16 2 are 32, so 0.2, so number of moles is 0.2 mole. Okay, so for methane, similarly for carbon dioxide we have to find what, that is it has been given mass is CO2 4.4 grams. Okay. Now, the molar mass of CO2 is 44 gram per mole. So, 44 gram means carbon's 12 contribution and plus 2 atoms of oxygen, that is 32 gram plus, that gives us what, 44 grams per mole. So, number of moles is equal to 4.4 gram divided by 44, okay, gram per mole. So, when we cancel this, it goes, then we will get what, 0.1 mole. Okay, students. So, from this we have obtained what, that is 0.2 moles and 0.1 moles. So, of what, that is CH4 and here of CO2. Okay, so I will write now that we have obtained what, NCH4 is 0.2 mole and NCO2 as 0.1 mole. Okay, now from the question, so now from the question we can see that the temperature is given. So, the temperature is given is 27 degree centigrade. So, we will change into Kelvin, 27 plus 273, so which will be 300 Kelvin. Okay. So, next, that is 9 decimeter cube. So, here R is, the pressure exerted should be in Pascal. So, R should be, that is 8.314 Pascal meter cube, K inverse, mole inverse. This is the value of R for Pascal. So, now we have been given what, this volume. Volume is in decimeter cube. So, 9 decimeter cube. So, we know 1 meter cube is equal to 10 to the power 3 decimeter cube. Okay. So, 1 meter cube by 10 to the power 3 decimeter cube is the CF, that is conversion factor. So, I will change this now, that is 9 decimeter cube into this factor, that is 1 meter cube divided by 10 to the power 3 decimeter cube. So, this goes off. So, 9 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube. So, we have changed into meter cube since here it is in meter cube. So our answer has to be in Pascal. Okay, so I'll just write here as 9 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube. Okay, so again, now we know last class we have studied that the partial pressure of this is the sum of total of the mixture, sum total of the mixture. So P mixture is equal to P of CH4, that is partial pressure of CH4 plus partial pressure of what, that is CO2. Okay, now we know that is PV is equal to nRT. Okay students, so now this is, we want the partial pressure of, suppose we want a partial pressure of CH4. So partial pressure of CH4 V is equal to number of moles of CH4 into R into T. So I can write partial pressure of CH4, okay, is equal to NCH4 RT divided by V. Okay, so this is our partial pressure of this, okay, that is methane. Similarly, for partial pressure of CO2, I can write that is N of CO2 RT by V. Okay, so I can write what, N of CH4 RT by V plus N of CO2 RT by V. So we can see here that RT by V is common in both case. So I'll take the common, that is RT by V. So that is number of moles of CH4, okay, plus number of moles of CO2. So we have already calculated the number of moles, that is 0.2 and 0.3. Okay, now the value of this R is 8.314, okay, that is Pascal meter cube K inverse mole inverse. So this is the value of R and temperature is 300. Okay, now into the sum of the total of this, so 0.1 plus 0.2, which is 0.3 mole. Okay, so by, we have the volume, so volume is 9 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube. Okay, so this gets cancelled and mole, okay, mole and this mole get cancelled. This is also in Kelvin, that is 300 Kelvin. So this Kelvin and this Kelvin cancel. So when we calculate this, so what, this will go 3 is 9. So this is 0.1, and this, when it will go up, so when we will calculate, we will get 3.14 into 10 to the power 4 Pascal. So this is the required answer. That is the total pressure of the mixture. Okay students, so in this way you can attempt the other question in the exercise, that is the total pressure of the mixture. Now let's see another question, and it is from 5.18. the 2.9 grams of gas at 95 degree centigrade occupied the same volume as 0.184 grams of hydrogen at 17 degree centigrade and the same pressure. What is the molar mass of the gas? Okay, so here it's a gas, we don't know which gas is, that is unknown gas, and here one more gas is there, that is hydrogen gas. So first, so mass of unknown gas, okay, that is what, mass of unknown gas I can write as 2.9 grams. So its molar mass also we don't know, so we have to calculate, okay, mass of the gas. So here for hydrogen, the mass is given as 0.184, okay, 0.184 gram. So we know molar mass of hydrogen is 2 gram per mole. Okay, so number of moles of H2 will be what, that is 0.184 grams divided by 2 gram per mole. Okay, so this gram goes off. So when we divide it will be what, 0.092 gram. Okay, so the number of moles is 0.092 gram. Okay students, so now we have calculated the number of moles also. So here it has been given as same pressure and same volume, and R is constant, as you all know. So according to ideal gas, okay, we know what ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. Here what all are constant, that is same pressure and same volume, okay, same pressure and same volume, and R is also constant. So we need, that is number of moles as well as temperature. So temperature first, for first gas, that is unknown gas, is given, that is T1 is 95 degree centigrade. So I will convert it into what, that is Kelvin. So 95 plus 273, which comes to be 8, and here 16, and 368 Kelvin. So for here T2, that is T2, so what is the second gas, the temperature is 17 degree centigrade. So here also I will convert this to Kelvin. So 17 plus 273, so it comes to be 10 and 189, that is 290 Kelvin. Okay, so we've got the number of moles as well as the temperature. Okay, so now for this gas I'll write n of unknown gas. Okay, number of moles of unknown gas, okay, into our T1. So T1 is this, now is equal to unknown gas of H2 into T2. Okay, so number of moles we can write that 2.9 by m. Okay, so the number of moles of unknown gas was 2.9 by that's gram per mole, E into T1. T1 is 368. Okay, now which is equal to the number of moles of hydrogen. We have calculated that it is 0.092 gram into temperature of T2, that is 290. Okay, so we got. So students, let's see a question from our exercise, that is 5.11. A student forget to add a reaction mixture to the round bottom flask at 27 degree centigrade, but put it on the flame. After a lapse of time, he realized his mistake. By using a pyrometer, he found that the temperature of the flask was 477 degree centigrade. What fraction of air would have been expelled? Okay, so here as this experiment is carried out in the lab, so there is no change in pressure. Okay, so what is given, the temperature T1 is given, and here T2 is also given. Temperature T1 is 27 degree centigrade, so 27 plus 273, which will be 300 Kelvin. Okay, so similarly for T2 it is 477 degree centigrade. Okay, so 477 degree centigrade plus 273, so I have changed it to Kelvin. So this is 10, this is 5, and this is 7, so 750 Kelvin. Okay students, so now the temperature, earlier it was 300, now 750. So volume, the student forgot to add that in the reaction mixture. So V1, say we can say it is VML. Okay, say VML. Okay, now V2 we have to find out. Okay, so from Charles law we know that pressure is constant, so V is directly proportional to T, that is Charles law is applicable. Okay, from Charles law. Okay, so I can write what, V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. Okay, so in the place of V1, I will write VML divided by T1 is 300. Okay, and V2 we have to find, so V2 divided by 750. Okay, 750 Kelvin. So this is also in Kelvin. So 750 K divided by 300 K into VML, okay, is equal to V2. So this K and this K will cancels. So the 0 0, so it is what, that is 25. So 10 is there, so 2.5. from here we got what, V2 is equal to 2.5 V of ML. Okay, now so here the volume of air expelled, volume of air expelled is equal to V2 minus V1. So here V2 is 2.5 V minus, here V1 is V, so it will be 1.5 V. Okay, so the question is, what fraction of air would be expelled? So fraction of air expelled is equal to total. The total is 1.5 by 2.5. Okay, so this V goes, so point goes, so it will be 3 by 5. The fraction is 3 by 5. So this is the required answer, that is the fraction of air would be, that is 3 by 5. Okay students, so students, from our question, that is 5.9, the density of a gas is found to be 5.46 gram per decimeter cube at 27 degree centigrade and under 2 bar pressure, what will be the density at STP? So we know density of gas is inversely proportional to its volume. Okay, now density is represented by rho. So suppose for worst case, we can write rho 1 directly inversely proportional to V1. Similarly for rho 2, I can write 1 by V2. Okay, so now when I divide this rho 1 by rho 2, so I will get 1 by V1 by 1 by V2. Okay, so rho 1 by rho 2, okay, rho 1 by rho 2 is equal to V2 by V1. Okay, for density 1 upon density 2 is equal to V2 by V1. Okay, so from combined gas law, we know P1 V1 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2. Okay, so I'll just shift this V1 over here. So our equation will be now P1 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2 V1. Okay, so this V2 by V1 I will substitute with the density. Okay, now P1 by T1 is equal to, I can write P2, okay, by T2 into that is rho 1 into rho 2. So this is our required formula to answer this question. Okay, so now what is there in the question, it is been asked that is a density of a gas is found to be this, that is 5.46 gram per decimeter cube density, that is the density of rho 1 at that 27 degree centigrade. So that is rho 1 is 5.46 gram decimeter cube. Okay. Now temperature T1 is given 27 degree centigrade. So 27 plus 273, which is 300 Kelvin. Okay. Now pressure P1 is we have what? P1 is 2 bar. Okay. 2 bar pressure. So this is for the first case. So second case, that is rho 1, rho 2 is equal to that we have to find. Okay. What will be the density at STP? So T1 is 0 plus 273, which is equal to 0 degree centigrade plus 273 Kelvin. Okay. This is standard temperature, and pressure, you know, this is T2. Okay. This is P2 is 1.013 bar. This is the standard pressure. Okay. Now we will substitute all this in the value. Now we have to find this rho 2. So I will write what I will write here. Rho 2 is equal to, we can write P2 into rho 1, P2 into rho 1 into T1, okay, divided by P1 into T2. Okay. So I will substitute all this value. Now we will get what? Rho 2 is equal to P2 is, now P2 is here 1.013 bar, okay, into rho 1. Rho 1 is 5.46 gram per decimeter cube into temperature T1. T1 is 300 Kelvin divided by P1 is 2 bar, okay, and T2 is, we have T2 is 273 Kelvin. So when we calculate this, we will be getting a value that is 3.04 gram. This is in gram decimeter cube, per decimeter cube. This is rho 2, that is the density at STP. Okay, students. So students, here a question is the that is the drain cleaner drainex contain a small bits of aluminium which reacts with caustic soda to produce hydrogen. What volume of hydrogen at 20 degree centigrade and 1 bar will be released when 0.15 grams of aluminium reacts? So first of all, we have to write the balance equation. So first of all, we have to write the balance equation. So aluminium, when it reacts with caustic soda, NaOH plus water, it gives NaAlO2. This is sodium meta aluminate plus hydrogen gas is released. So first of all, we have to balance here. So here 2 hydrogen, here 3 hydrogen is there. So put 3 over here. So now here 2, okay, now here also 2, so 6 balanced. Now here again 2, so here 2, so this equation is balanced. Okay. Now we know that the atomic mass of aluminium is 27 gram. So here it is 2 moles, so 2 into 27 grams, that means 54 grams. Okay. Now here the hydrogen released is, that is, we know that 1 mole of gas, the volume will be 22400 ml. Okay. For 3 moles, that is 3 into 22400 ml. Okay. Now, so we can write what? 54 grams of aluminium at NTP releases hydrogen gas is equal to 3 into 22400 ml. Okay. Now, here when 0.15 grams of aluminium will react, so we'll write 0.15 grams of Al at NTP will release H2 gas is 3 into 22400, okay, 22400 into what we have, that is into 0.15 grams divided by 54 grams. Okay, so when we calculate, it comes to be 186.7 ml. So we got the volume, that is V1 at NTP condition. So here V1 is 186, okay, 186.7 ml, and here the temperature is, that is T1, which is 0 plus 273, so 273 Kelvin, this is for NTP condition, okay, this is for NTP condition. And the pressure is 1.013 bar, okay, standard temperature pressure. So at the given condition, for the given condition we have condition, that is the condition is 20 and 1 bar, then temperature is, that is T2 is 20 plus 273, which is 293 Kelvin, okay, or then P2 is 1 bar, okay students. So P2 is 1 bar, and then V2 we have to find, okay. So we have to find the V2. So from combined gas law, we know P1 V1 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2, okay. So we have to find the V2. So we can write V2 as P1 V1 into T2 divided by P2 into T1. Okay. When we substitute the value of P1, P1 is here 1.013 bar. Okay. Into V1. V1 is 186.7 ml. Into T2, T2 is 293 divided by P2 is 1 bar, and T1 is 273 Kelvin. Okay, so when we calculate this, the value comes to be 203 ml. So the volume, that is V2, will be 203 ml at the given condition of 20 degree and 1 bar. So students, in the next class we will see another topic. We will deal with another topic. Thank you very much.